Hello friends, I'm Satish from ssclasses.in and welcome to this particular video of physical chemistry. फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री का हम सेकेंड चैप्टर इस वीडियो में देखेंगे कम्प्लीटली और नाम है चैप्टर का न्यूक्लियर केमिस्ट्री. न्यूक्लियर केमिस्ट्री इज ऑल्सो एन ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट ऑफ TYBSE, सो वी विल ट्राई ऑन इट पर्टिकुलरली MCQs विद आंसर्स ऑल्सो. दोस्तों अगर आप चैनल पर नए हो तो जल्दी से सब्सक्राइब का बटन दबा लीजिए और नोटिफिकेशन भी ऑन कर लीजिए क्योंकि ईच वीडियो अब तक आना चाहिए. हमारे चैनल का प्लेलिस्ट देखिए, वीडियोस देखिए, कंटिन्यूसली वीडियोस आपको TYBSE के मिल जाएंगे. इंडस्ट्रियल केमिस्ट्री के 4 वीडियोस, इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री के 4 वीडियोस. ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री तो सबसे बेस्ट है हमारे चैनल पर, देख सकते हैं आप. वीडियोस देख लीजिए और कमेंट कर लीजिए, बताइए कि कैसा वीडियो है. ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री का जो कम्प्लीटली क्रेडिट जाता है वो हमारी केमिस्ट्री एक्सपर्ट सोहनी को जाता है. सो आप बताइए कि वीडियो कैसा है, कमेंट कर लीजिए कि आपको वीडियो कैसे लगते हैं. वेट करेंगे आपके कमेंट के लिए. फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री का हमने एक वीडियो कवर किया है जिसका नाम था इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल सेल्स और सेकेंड वीडियो है आज का न्यूक्लियर केमिस्ट्री इस चैप्टर पर.
सो फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, दिस टू आर द न्यूक्लियर एंड दिस वी हैव टू चूज whether these are the isobars or isotopes or isotones or isomers. So friends, 14, 6 and 8. So 14 is a mass number, 6 is the atomic number and 8 is the neutron. Remember, 8 plus 6 that is mass number, that means the proton plus neutron, 6 plus 8 this is 14, right? So ये identification होता है, ये A यानी कि atomic mass है, फिर आप mass number बोलते हैं इसको, 6 फिर से एक बार बता रहा हूँ, एटॉमिक नंबर बोलते हैं और 8 को हम बोलते हैं न्यूट्रॉन्स, नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स. ओके, सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय आइसोबार्स? सो आइसोबार्स दैट मींस दिस आर द न्यूक्लाई ऑफ नेबरिंग एलिमेंट्स. नेबरिंग एलिमेंट्स कुछ होते हैं जैसे कि बताओ तो अर्गॉन, पोटेशियम, देन कैल्शियम, ऐसे राइट, हैविंग द सेम नंबर ऑफ मास नंबर बट दे डिफर इन एटॉमिक नंबर, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज आइसोबार्स. सो आइसोटोप्स मीन्स दिस आर न्यूक्लियर दैट बिलोंग्स टू सेम एलिमेंट्स, सेम एलिमेंट के ये न्यूक्लाइज होते हैं एंड इट कंटेन्स सेम नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स, राइट. सो देयर फॉर द एटॉमिक नंबर इज सेम बट द मास नंबर डिफरेंस, सो दैट न्यूक्लियाइज आर नोन एज आइसोटोप्स. आइसोटोन्स मीन्स वॉट आर, दिस आर द न्यूक्लियर दैट कंटेन्स सेम नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स, न्यूट्रॉन्स सेम होता है बट द प्रोटॉन्स इज डिफरेंट, दैट मीन्स द मास नंबर इज वेरियस, mass number is different for that elements. Last one, isomers. Isomers mean the nuclei that containing the same number of protons and neutrons, that means the same number of mass number. So these are the two different elements, right? Two different elements means this is called as isobars. Isobars, this is isobars, only the mass number is same but the atomic number, that means number of protons and number of neutrons, are different. Next question, we have one atomic mass unit is equals to AMU, means atomic mass unit. So options here are in the gram. So the correct option for this question, that means the one atomic mass unit equals to how many gram. So this is option number second for this question. Third question, these are the, again nuclei are given. So here you can notice 11, 11 and 11. This is an atomic number, that means the number of protons present in that nuclei. But the atomic mass or the mass number, that is 22, 23 and 24 are respectively. Here same metal is, that is a sodium. So these are the isotopes. So here answer is a reversed firstly. So option number second is for this question, right now. Now next question, 4 number question, binding energy of a nucleus is 2 mass number. So kya hai, same as to mass number or the inversely proportional to the mass number or directly proportional or none of these. So here remember, this is always directly proportional to mass number. Binding energy is denoted by capital E and mass number is denoted by A. So this question may be asked in the symbolic form also. Now, fifth number question, the graph of packing fraction versus mass number is dash dash to that of E bar. E bar is the average binding energy and A is mass number. So here same as or the exactly opposite or nearly same, last one nearly opposite. So this is exactly opposite to these graphs, means these graphs are exactly opposite to each other. Now, sixth number question, in 1986, discovered radioactivity. So we have to select the which scientist discovered this radioactivity in 1986. Remember, this is a very important question and the controversy will be created in this particular question. But you have to remember the particular name of scientist, and the scientist is called as Henri Becquerel. This is a scientist who discovered the radioactivity firstly. Now, seventh number question. Curie artificially prepared crystals of. So which are the that crystals which are artificially prepared by Curie? So here uranium or the copper or thorium, and last one is chalcolite. Correct option for this question is last number, and that is chalcolite. Eighth number question. Which radioactive element was found by Marie Curie and Pierre Curie? They work on the radioactivity. Also they found or the discovered element called polonium or thorium or uranium. Last one is none of these. So here correct option is polonium. So here polonium was discovered from their country name, and that is Poland. So ninth number question. Which radioactive elements occurs naturally? So here radium or thorium or uranium. Last one is all of these. So here correct option is all of these, because all the elements are A, T, H and U, that is radium, thorium and uranium. So all these elements are occurring in nature. 10 number question. One Curie is one CI. CI is a symbol for Curie, and the Curie is a unit of radioactivity. So here options, this is in terms of disintegration, second inverse, and this is another Becquerel, or here another two options are there. But the important controversy, again I am telling that Curie and this Becquerel were the two scientists, right? Becquerel was discovered the term radioactivity, but the unit of radioactivity was given by Curie. So this unit in terms of Curie, and that is, so in terms of disintegration, this is 3.7 into 10 to the power 10 disintegration, second inverse. Now next question, 11 number question. Which radioactive element emits alpha and beta radiations? Thorium 232 and radium 226, radon 222, last one polonium 218. So here last one element, that is polonium, was discovered by Marie Curie and Pierre Curie, which emits alpha and beta radiations, and thorium, radium and radon is emitting the only alpha radiations, while polonium is emitting alpha as well as beta radiations. Now 12 number question. Half-life period and average life of radioactive element are related as. So what is the relation between half-life period and the average life period of radioactive element? So this is like this. One option, first option, this is second option, third option, and this is last option. So you have to remember the first option is correct for this question, and this is the relation between this half-life period and average life. 13 number question. Half-life period of any radioactive element is. We have to choose a dependency, that is depending on temperature or depending on pressure or definite, and last one is variable. So I want to clear that the half-life of period is independent on all the variables, that is temperature, pressures and other also. Half-life period is can't be changed, so therefore the half-life period is definite. Remember. Now 14 number question. Dead time of the GM counter, that is Geiger-Müller counter, is observed due to. Options: gas multiplication or the quenching process, Geiger threshold, last one is difference in mobilities of positive and negative ions. Option correct here is gas multiplication. Now next number question, that is 15 number question. 228 radium 88 is radioactive element. This is passes spontaneously to 228 AC to 89 due to. So here options alpha decay, K capture, next one is positron emission, last one is electron emission. Here you must know that the radium and actinium, that is Ra and Ac, are the beta rays. And this contains electrons, lot of electrons containing. And during conversion of neutron and proton, the electrons must be ejected, that is emission, right? So here correct option is electron emission for this question. Now 16 number question. maximum average binding energy per nucleons indicates. So what is that indication? Maximum stability of nucleus, or the minimum stability of nucleus, or the radioactivity. Last one is spin of nucleons. So here the option number first is correct, maximum stability of nucleus. Now next question, 17 number question, the end product of 238 uranium is. So what is that? Thorium here given, here carbon is given, 206 lead is given, that is Pb. Last one is hydrogen. So here the correct option is third one, that is 206 Pb, that is lead, right? So this is the end product of this 238 uranium. 18 number question, radioisotopes have been made for understanding of options hypertension or hyperthyroidism, diabetes mellitus, or hypertriglyceridemia. So correct option is number second, and that is hyperthyroidism. This is the correct option for this question. 3H upon 1H is used to know age of. So options are water sample, or minerals, or rock samples, or earth. So this is used to know the age of water sample, right? Now 20 number question, 14C dating is used. So dating for irradiation of seeds, to control predatory insects, or the as a fertilizer. Last one is to know the age of dead organism. So correct option is last one, to know the age of dead organisms. Now next one question, 21st question, the most common filling material in Jaeger-Müller counter is. First option is chlorine plus vapor of ethyl iodide. Next option is neon plus ozone. Next option is fluorine and bromine. Last option is argon plus vapor of ethyl alcohol. So you have to remember, in the GM counter or the Jaeger-Müller counter, the most of the noble gases are presented like as argon and neon. Also vapor of ethyl alcohol or the ethyl iodide or halogen gas also used for the material of a GM counter. So here argon is there, here neon is there, but the ozone can't be presented, right? This A and C must be eliminated. Last one is vapor of ethyl alcohol, ethyl iodide, or option alternative is halogen gas, but this is not presented here. So last one option is correct for this question, argon plus vapor of ethyl alcohol. 22 number question, that is the daughter of form on beta minus emission is displaced in the periodic table. This is one place to the left of parent, one place to the right of parent, two places to the left of the parent, and last one is two places to the right of the parent. So correct option for this is one place to the right of the parent. This is correct option for beta emission. 232 radon, this is iron, right, has a half-life of 3.83 days, and then what will be the lambda? So here lambda is the disintegration constant. So we have to calculate this lambda, that means the disintegration constant, by using formula. I will show you the formula to find this lambda. Firstly, look at the options, like these options, day inverse. So the calculation like this, disintegration constant, that is lambda equals to 0.693 upon this half life, that is T half. And calculate this, you will get the correct answer, and correct answer is number one option, 0.1809 day inverse. 24 number question, theoretically mass of A upon Z X is equals to. So here options like these options, but the correct option for this question is number three, that is this one formula, remember. Last one question from this video, the time required for 99.9% disintegration of every ratio element is nearly. Option number one is 10 times its disintegration constant, that is lambda, or 10 times its atomic number, that is Z, and 10 times its half-life, T half. Last one is 10 times its binding energy, that is E. You must know the all the symbols, right? So the correct option for this question is 10 times its half-life. So friends, I hope these 25 questions are most expected for examination. So friends, for this video, this is the end of part, and we will be meet in the next video.